Hi, this is Chase Cunningham, owner of Moorhead Motorsports and Team Media All-Stars rider. We're sitting here at Early Wine Racing in Maysville, Kentucky. And what I have behind me is our project Can-Am DS450. When we tested this bike back in October at our shootout, we really liked the bike's suspension. We thought it had a pretty good amount of power, and it just felt really comfortable. The bike was just super comfortable to ride on. And Can-Am is actually, this year, they're offering like over $1 million in contingency for racers. So we knew this bike was gonna get picked up by a lot of racers looking to earn a little bit of extra money and put money back in their pocket from actually racing. So what we wanted to do is take what we thought was a pretty good platform to begin with, and we wanted to improve on a few things that it needed in order to be competitive at the national level. Our original plan for this bike and for this build was for me to be able to race it here at Early Wine Racing during their winter series. I've been pro champion for 2 years in a row coming into this year, and I really liked this Can-Am and I thought that we could win on it. And what we did, we changed some things around on the bike, and we just had got it to where we thought it was really gonna be competitive. We changed, you know, the shocks and a few other minor things. And lo and behold, I had an accident in here practicing one day and I broke my collarbone. So I've been out for about 3 months and I didn't really get a chance to race it, but I know this thing can be competitive as we built it. When we tested this bike back in October, we had it bone stock, and then some when I rode it in here, what we mainly noticed about the suspension is that in stock form, it's probably the best 450 on the market as far as plushness and, you know, the way the suspension works up and down and the way it feels underneath you. The biggest problem we had was the fact that we couldn't get the bike to sit low enough and it wanted to roll in the corners just because of its high center of gravity. So what we've done, we sent the shocks off to Race Tech, and they put their gold valve kit in it, and they put a different shim stack in it. They did it for my weight and basically the kind of riding that I told them we were going to be doing this winter. We've got our triple rate, as you can see, and we've got plenty of room here. Before, when it was stock, you know, I had to run them all the way up into here to get it lower. But with this new spring rate that they've got, we've got plenty of adjustment either way on our preload. And we've still got plenty of adjustment up here on our compression. And our back Race Tech shock has been changed from a single rate to a dual rate. It's got, once again, it's got their shim kit in it, and it's also got their valving, their gold valve kit. They completely changed the back shock. And I also had them, whenever I talked to them, I had them put a shorter bumper on this back shock, and what that does is it lets us use more of the shock shaft. With a taller bumper, a lot of times if you try to run your suspension a little bit softer, which is what we're doing to get it lower, if you run a taller bumper, then your shock, you know, you don't have enough room between your body and your bumper and it'll start to pack on you. But with this shorter Race Tech bumper, we've got tons of room before our bumper starts packing up on the bottom of our shock body. These days, your modern 450s, they've all got rebuildable shocks. A lot of guys don't realize how good these shocks can be. Most of them will just, they'll take them off, they'll throw them in the garage, they'll put them on a shelf, they'll collect dust. But guys, don't do that. Race Tech has got this kit, and it's amazing. To me, I didn't realize that these were shocks that just anybody could get off the shelf. I thought when I got these shocks and I put them on the bike, got it set up, and I started riding it, I thought these were like maybe one-off shocks, that they had built me a shock that, you know, was just special, and you just, you know, you couldn't get it unless you were, you know, with ATVOnDemand.com. But they really do. They work that well. I don't know really how much more you could expect out of a full aftermarket shock than that what these revalves are delivering for us on the track.